G'day everybody, welcome back. Last week I did the tutorial of the deep and I created this picture of the creature here, and this week I'm going to show you how I created the creature and made this picture that you can see here. So as usual, let's get started. I'm going to come up here to this picture here of the sub, and you can see that I've already used my selection brush tool and made a selection all the way around the sub here. So we want to get rid of the background, so I'm just going to copy that selection with a command J, and I'm going to turn off the background. So we've just got the sub on its own layer without the background. Let's get rid of those marching ants with a command D. Make sure that we're on our move tool here, and I'm just going to resize the sub, move it into the middle here so it gives us a little bit more room to work on the sub here. The picture of the creature is this one here, and I could use my flood fill selection tool with a tolerance of about 8 to get rid of the whole black background, but I just want the picture of the creature, this one here, so I am going to use my selection brush tool. Don't forget you can resize your brush with your right and left bracket keys. I'm going to start off with a fairly small brush, and I'm just going to go around and make a selection of this creature here. Don't forget you can hold your option key down to subtract the selection. So if I hold option key, I can just subtract the selection here, and then taking my finger off the option key, I can carry on selecting the creature. I'm just going to go around and select this creature now. Once you've got your creature all selected, come up here to refine and just have a quick look. I'm just going to make a little bit of a feather on here, maybe about 3. That's okay. Come down here to the output box and click on new layer and click apply. That'll give us this creature just on a layer by itself. I'm going to take the opportunity to use my erase brush tool, just with my brush a little bit bigger, just to clean up these little scraggly bits that are left over, just to make that a little bit cleaner. Once you're happy, we can just make sure we're on this layer, and now we can just copy our creature with a command C, come over to our sub, and go command V. So we've got our creature here. Make sure we're on our move tool, and just resize our creature, and put the creature into position. I'm going to put mine about here, just on top of the sub. But while we're on our creature layer here, I'm just going to select this tentacle here, make a selection with my selection brush tool. And I'm going to copy that leg with a command J. So command J. Now we can get rid of those marching ants with our command D. Back up here to our move tool, and we're going to take that copy and just move it around, and I'm going to place it about here. I'm going to place it behind the sub, so let's drag that down behind the sub. And now it looks like that leg is part of this leg or tentacle here. Let's make another copy with another command J and move that one. I'm up here to arrange and flip horizontal. I'm going to put that one just about here. Okay, we've got our two legs or tentacles in the background. Let's come back up to the layer of our creature here, and we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to do some cutting and pasting. So we're going to come over here to our selection brush tool again, and each one of these tentacles or legs we're going to select, and then we're going to cut and paste. So we're going to make a selection of it, of this tentacle here. And on our keyboard, we can hit Command X to cut it, and you can see that I've cut it out, and then Command V to paste it back. Let's get rid of our marching ants. Back onto our creature layer, and we're going to do the same for each of these legs or tentacles here as well. Don't forget each time that you cut and paste to come back to the creature layer before you start on the next leg or tentacle. Holding my option key because I went a little bit too far there. Command X, Command V, get rid of the marching ants. Okay, so as you can see now, we've got all these independent tentacles cut out, and now we can use our mesh warp tool to manipulate each of these legs or tentacles. So we'll start on the top one here, and I'm going to come over here to my mesh warp tool. This one I'm simply just going to bring down a little bit. About there, looks pretty good, and I'm going to hit apply. Come to the next tentacle here, again on our mesh warp tool, and this one I want this tentacle to look like it's going behind this tank here. So I'm going to drag this one back and just use these little nodules here to manipulate that tentacle. And that looks good about there. So I'm going to hit apply on that one. This tentacle here, the next one, I want to make it looking like it's going into this porthole. So again, on my mesh warp tool, and I'm just going to drag that back. Just use these little modules again to manipulate that. And that looks pretty good. So I'm going to hit apply on that one. This tentacle, I'm going to make it look like it's going through the back of the tank here. So again, on our mesh warp tool, going to drag that back and just move that around. And that looks good about there. So let's hit apply. Now you can see we've got some of the previous when we did the cut and paste is left over here. So we'll take the opportunity now to come back onto the creature layer, grab our erase brush tool, make our erase brush a little bit bigger and get rid of those. Tidy that up a little bit while we're here. Okay, let's click on the top tentacle here. Hold our shift key down and click on the creature. I'm going to group them together with a command G. Let's call that one legs above. And now on that group, the legs above group, we're going to add a mask. We've got our mask here now. We'll grab our brush, nice soft brush, and we'll make sure that we're painting in black here. Our flow can be 25%. Let's make that brush a little bit bigger and let's zoom in. I'm using my command plus to zoom in a little bit. Brush a little bit smaller, and then on that mask, we're just going to paint away a little bit of this tentacle here so it looks like it's going behind that tank. That looks okay. So let's do this one. So it looks like it's going into that porthole there. And remember, I'm doing this quite quickly. So just when you do it, make sure you take your time. And this one just behind this tank here. Okay, that looks pretty good. Command 0 to get back to the normal size. And now we're going to add some other legs. So we're going to use these ones at the back here again. So let's come down here under the sub and go Command J. Come up here to our move tool. And this one we can move around the back as an extension of this tentacle here. So let's make that a little bit thinner. There we go, got that flow going from this tentacle around the back and back behind the tank again. Let's make another copy, Command J. Move this one down here and arrange flip horizontal. We can move it into place by this tank here. I'm going to bring this one up into the legs above group. So let's bring that one up all the way up to the legs above group, so it's above here. So I want it to make it look like it's coming out in between these two tanks. So back on our mask layer, back on our brush, we're still at 25% and we're still painting in black. So let's just get rid of some of that. That makes it look like that tentacle is flowing through the tank and behind the tank. Back on my mask just to clean that up a little bit. Okay, so I'm happy with that. So we've got two other legs to fix up here. Again, back down on our legs below the tank, make another copy. back on our move tool, and this one we're going to make an extension of this leg. Let's just put that here. And looks good about there. So on that tentacle or leg here, I'll just grab my erase brush tool and just erase that bit behind there. And then back up here to our mask, onto our brush. Still got 25% and we're still in black, and we'll just blend this tentacle in a little bit here. That looks pretty good. And I might just zoom in and just where this hook is here on the mask, I might just bring that hook that looks like it's going around the creature here. And that looks pretty good. And the reason we can do that with the mask is because this tentacle here is part of this group that's got the mask on it. So we can just mask that part of the tentacle out. Okay, Command 0 to get back to normal size. Just one more leg to fix up here. So again, let's make another copy of our leg up here again, this one here. Command J, let's move that one into place. Let's come up here to arrange and flip horizontal. Grab this little node here and turn it around. We'll place it underneath this leg and just make it a bit thinner. Now what I'm going to do is just mask out this tentacle till it blends in with this one. So let's come here to the tentacle, which is in the legs above. Grab our brush, still got our 25% and still in black, making my brush bigger. Make sure I'm on the mask layer now, and I'm just going to remove some of that tentacle and blend it in with this one. And then I'm just going to erase a bit of the tentacle underneath here, which I think it's this one here. Yes. Grab my erase brush tool and just erase that bit behind. So now we've got that tentacle blended in as well. So there we go. We've got our creature in place. I hope that wasn't too confusing. Just to make sure that we can use the mask on any of the legs that are above. And then all these legs that are underneath the sub behind, we just used our erase brush tool. Let's click on the first leg that's under the sub and then click on the last one holding shift down and group those, and we'll call those legs below and hit enter. So now we've got our group of legs above and legs below. So we're ready to colorize our creature now. So let's come down here to adjustments and recolor and put that right on top for now. Let's move the hue to the green to make our monster or creature nice and green. And let's make a duplicate copy of that, Command J. Then we're going to clip one of these recolors to each of the groups here. So first one we can grab and clip it to the legs above. Next one, we can grab the other recolor and clip it to the legs below. That will make just our creature green. We're going to add another recolor right on top. This one we want to be red, so that's fine. But on that recolor, we're going to invert it. So Command I to invert. Come back to our brush tool. We'll bring the flow all the way up to 100%. And we'll swap over our colors with X on the keyboard, so we're painting in white. And we're going to paint that red color into our eye. And we can do that because we've inverted this recolor adjustment. So let's just paint that red in the eye here. There we go. The other thing I want to do is bring out some of these highlights, the white highlights. So right on top of that recolor, I'm going to add a new pixel layer. Going to change the blend mode to overlay. So right on that pixel layer, brand new pixel layer, blend mode overlay. We've still got our brush, We're still at 100% on our flow and we're still painting in white. So let's just paint in those highlights. There we go. Command 0 on our keyboard to get back to normal size. There's one other thing that we can do to make this look a little bit better. I'm going to come down here to our sub, the picture of our submarine, and we're going to add an exposure adjustment right on top here and then bring it down and clip it just to the sub. And then we're going to make that really dark, just like that. And then on the exposure adjustment, we're going to invert that as well with a Command I. Still got our brush, bringing our flow back down now, all the way back down to 10%. Grabbing our brush, let's make it a sort of, not as soft, but still a softer brush. We're going to be painting in white. Make sure our flow went to 10. It's gone back up to 100 here, so let's make sure that flow is on 10%. Okay, brush, I'm making it a little bit bigger with my right and left bracket keys. Now I'm going to paint in the shadow for the creature here. So just on that sub, I'm painting in some shadow just to give it a little bit of depth. You can see we still got some scraggly bits left over as well, and we can fix those while we're here. That's on the legs above layer in the creature here. So let's grab our erase brush tool and we can just take care of that little scraggly bit there. While I'm here, I might make my brush a little bit smaller and just take away that bit of leg there so it looks like that's flowing into here. And you can see some of these legs here, we've sort of got some cracking going on. You can fix those if you like. Just click on the leg that's got the sort of cracking here. Come back over here to the mesh warp tool. We can just pull that up a little bit and hit apply. Do the same to this leg here. Back to our mesh warp tool. We can just pull that up a little bit and over and hit apply. We can clean all that up. So Command 0. In the end, we can just highlight all the layers now. Holding our shift, highlight all the layers. Command G to make one great big group of our creature. That gives us the opportunity now to move that creature as one. So there you go, everybody. That is how I created the creature for my tutorial that I uploaded last week called The Deep. The Affinity photo file for this tutorial with all the layers is available on the Buy Me a Coffee site for you to download absolutely free. You can also support my channel there as well. But if you did like the tutorial this week, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you know when I upload another video. But until next time, I'll say to you, stay well. Stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.